Welcome back to Advanced Biomechanics on Catalyst University. My name is Kevin Togoff. Please make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel for future videos and notifications. In this video, we're going to talk about different strategies to maintaining balance during an unexpected perturbation to the body. And so these are reactive postural adjustment strategies that we're going to see during standing. And those are the ankle strategy, the hip strategy, and the step strategy. Now, remember that reactive postural adjustments are adjustments made throughout the body to maintain balance if there's an unexpected perturbation. So if you had some kind of shove to your backside, a shove to your forward side, or even the lateral sides, left or right, how do you maintain balance? Well, the strategy that your body uses to maintain that balance can depend a lot on your base of support, but also on the magnitude or amplitude of that perturbation, okay? And so what we're going to see are these three strategies. We're going to start with the ankle strategy. This is something that we're going to see when the amplitude of the unexpected perturbation is very small, okay? So it's a weak perturbation. And it's also something that we generally see when we have a normal base of support. So feet are just shoulder width apart. In other words, we don't have a narrow base of support. Now, when this perturbation is very small, the inner ear, that is the vestibular apparatus, is really not going to detect any changes or any problems with balance because the head's really not going to move all that much if the perturbation's small, okay? In these cases, if you were hit with something really hard or high amplitude, yeah, your head would probably move significantly and therefore your vestibular system would sense it. But if the perturbation's really small, your inner ear is not going to sense anything. And so it's really going to be the ankle proprioceptors that are going to detect these changes, this perturbation or this problem with the balance. It's just going to be really small. And so what you see in the ankle strategy is just a small amplitude sway at the ankle, and the hips and head move in the same direction. Now in this case, this woman appears to be leaning a little bit forward. Now, what's keeping her from actually falling forward on her face? Well, it's actually the posterior muscles of the leg right here, probably gastrocnemius and soleus. They're actually contracting to prevent the tibia from moving too far forward at the ankle joint. If the tibia moved too far forward, then all of her would fall forward and it'd be a mess. So the gastrocnemius and the soleus contract to prevent the tibia from moving too far forward over the ankle joint, and so it keeps her upright. Conversely, if we had another situation where she was kind of leaned back a little bit, the reason she wouldn't be falling, if this were an ankle strategy, would actually be the anterior muscle, tibialis anterior, contracting to keep the tibia from moving too far backward over the ankle joint. Okay? And this is only something that we see when the perturbation is small. If the perturbation was large, she'd be hit with enough force where these muscles of the leg, whether it be the tibialis anterior or the gastrocnemius and soleus in this case, they'd be too weak to keep her upright like this. She'd have to either bend forward at the hips or actually take a step forward to catch her balance. So ankle strategy is only something we see when the unexpected perturbation is small. And one thing I'll also mention is that the muscle activation is distal to proximal. So the first thing we're going to see activated are these muscles of the leg. In this case, it's going to be gastrocnemius and soleus. Now the second strategy is something that we see in the case of a large or fast perturbation. And actually so is the third one. The difference between these has to do with the base of support. If we're going to use the hip strategy, that's going to be something where the base of support is narrow, and then it's done in response to a large amplitude unexpected perturbation. So either a large amplitude or the perturbation is fast. So if it were fast, ankle strategy wouldn't be sufficient. You'd fall over. Now, if you're hit with a large or fast perturbation, then it's reasonable to say that your head is going to come out of balance, okay? Whether it's to the right, to the left, down, or up. And so your inner ear is going to be able to sense that there's a disturbance with balance. And so in the case of the hip strategy, and actually what we'll see in the step strategy, is that these changes are detected through the vestibular system rather than proprioceptors. Here, there wasn't a big enough change in balance of the head to affect the inner ear. So proprioceptors were all that were necessary. In the hip strategy and step strategy, the perturbation is large enough to cause the head to come out of equilibrium, and therefore the vestibular system is going to pick up on that in the inner ear. Now, in hip strategy, what happens is you have this large perturbation, and the head and hips are going to move in opposite directions. So notice in this case, her hips actually moved backward, but then her head actually moved forward. Now, in the other direction, we obviously don't have as much range of motion, but you could have a case where the hips move forward and the head moves backwards. Likewise, in the lateral direction, if the hips were kind of to move to the left, the head would then move to the right. And so the key with a hip strategy is really just that the head and hips move in opposite directions. It's also worth noting that the hip strategy muscle activation is opposite that what we see in the ankle strategy, in the sense that muscle activation for the hip strategy occurs proximal to distal. So what we would actually see is that the hip muscles would actually activate before the muscles controlling the knee, and then before the muscles controlling the ankle, they would actually be last. But this is generally what we would see if the base of support was narrow. If we go back to having a regular shoulder width distance base of support and have the same large or fast unexpected perturbation, then we're dealing more with a step strategy. Again, because the perturbation is large enough or fast enough to really take the head out of equilibrium, the inner ear is what's going to sense this, and so, again, going to be detected via the vestibular system in the inner ear. Now, in the case of the step strategy, what's going to happen is you're going to have a change in the base of support such that there is a step. I think that's pretty straightforward. So the large perturbation in this case caused her to have to take a step in one direction or another. In general, with the step strategy, whatever direction that the force of perturbation is coming from, the limb that takes the step will move in the opposite direction. In other words, if the perturbation was coming from the front, then the limb that moves, that is the leg, would move backwards. If the perturbation were coming from the backside, then the leg that moves would move forward. If the perturbation were coming from the left side, then the leg that moves would move to the right. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. And the muscle activation, it really not proximal to distal or anything like that. It's just whatever you would expect if you were walking and a step occurred. Now, obviously, the mechanics of this step are going to be a little bit different than what we see in the gait cycle. But generally speaking, the same things that you would see in a step in the gait cycle would be similar to what would happen in the step strategy to an RPA. Okay? So hopefully this video gave you a good understanding of the reactive postural adjustment strategies that we can use to maintain balance in the event that there's some kind of perturbation or some kind of disturbance to the balance. Okay? Please make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel for future videos and notifications. Thank you.